creating the terrain. Hello and welcome to the second part of this course. In this part, we'll create the base for our texture, the floor we need to place the tiles on. It's important that we know two things when we create our texture. The first is that the base must be a perfect square. It should be the same size on all four sides. And the second is that if something sticks out on one side, then it has to be the same on the other side too, so the texture fits in perfectly. But I'll explain this properly in the next video. Once our tiles are finished, we'll create a level in our subtool menu. The level that ZBrush makes for us is perfect for tiles, so we just need to place it in the direction that we want and scale it to the size we want our tiled floor. The bigger we make it, the more tiles will fit, and obviously, the smaller we make it, the less tiles will fit. You can use the transpose master to rotate and scale. Remember, you can square up the camera views by pressing shift to do this better. When our level is in place and scaled, we need to duplicate it. One will be our base, the earth where the tiles will be placed, and the other will just be a mold to make sure everything fits perfectly. Right now, we'll just work with one of the levels. Subdivide the level a few times. It's important to turn off the smooth, so the edges of the level aren't smoothened. Otherwise, it would be totally flat and have 90 degrees on the corners. To make the earth, we're going to use the same method we used to get that grainy texture on our tiles, but with one difference. In this case, we need the earth to be lumpier in some areas and sunken in others. This is important, so our base isn't completely flat and it looks more realistic. So, we'll use the layer brush without the default alpha and an adjustable intensity depending on how strongly we want to apply our effects. Control the volumes of the level you're creating and apply the layer brush all over the floor. For this, you'll need to constantly rotate the level and place it in a horizontal view. You can also make it small and create some smaller dents or protruding areas. Then, to add some more detail, we're going to make some stones for our floor. For this, we'll go to Subtool menu and select a cube. You need to subdivide it a few times, although not too much, as it's going to be quite small anyway. With Trim Dynamic, soften all the corners abruptly. When we like the shape, use the Trim Adaptive to make some of the faces harder. In this case, the stones are going to be very small, so we don't need to add a great amount of detail, as you'll barely be able to see them. We can hide the subtools that we won't be using at the moment, so it's easier to work. To hide them, just click on the eye icon on each subtool in the subtool menu. With the transpose master, place and lower the stone until it's the scale we want and it's in a position where it's touching the floor. It's important not to skip this step. Place the stone wherever you like, and now we're going to duplicate the stone using the same subtool. First, we need to delete all the subdivisions it has by going to the geometry menu and pressing lower. When the subdivisions are deleted, simply duplicate the stone selecting Transpose Master and pressing the white circle in the middle while holding down Ctrl and dragging. This way our stone is masked and we've created a copy of it. Just like this, we'll place stones all over the terrain, making sure all the stones are at the height of the terrain, that none of them are floating. As the stones we're duplicating are masked, we can rotate, scale or modify them however we like without any problems. This will give us plenty of maneuverability when we need various stones quickly and easily. As I always say, it's important to have references at hand of what we're creating. You can observe how stones are usually placed or piled on the floor. Are they all together? Are they scattered? Depending on the type of terrain, try out different shapes. And maybe you could even sculpt some small details like twigs, branches, leaves, or anything you think would work for your tiled floor. When all the stones are in place, you could also make some little mounds of earth around them, selecting again the level for the earth and using the layer brush with the same settings as before, or the move brush, adjust the areas around the stones. We'll get better details like this, as it's easy to create different heights, making it more realistic. Once we have the results we were looking for with the stones, we can add a few extra touches to the floor and make the other level visible that we duplicated earlier. Using it as a guide, we can make some parts of the terrain stick out more to create different heights. So this is the base for our tileable texture. The next thing we'll do is finishing our texture and make sure it fits perfectly in all areas. I'll see you in the next and final lesson.